stuck in here.
Moore Park College, we're here to see you.
All right, so today we have a very exciting opportunity to go to see the Moore Park College Zoo. And the kids are going to be able to ride on giraffes.
What?
Swing on branches with orangutans. Rocktard's going to sleep in the mane of a lion. It should be pretty exciting.
Wait,
what?
I don't think I agreed to that.
You're wrestling with a Bengal tiger. What are you talking about? I sent you the script.
Man,
it's pretty up here. I've never been to Moore Park.
Can I fight with the tiger?
Yeah, who wants to fight with the tiger? Yay!
Not me.
Baby Tart. She's the one that has her head on her shoulders. So the very first meeting we have from the email I got was we have a meeting with a giant tortoise. Like Crush from Nemo.
Yeah.
Right, Rocktard? Aw. He's been screaming the whole way.
No.
He finally fell asleep.
You gotta be kidding me.
Wake him up. Do we bring the stroller?
Yes.
Oh, man. I was gonna... Oh, zoo! Turn right. Let's go see the animals!
How old is this guy?
89.
89 years old. What's his name?
His name's
what?
Clarence.
Clarence? Hey, guys. Totally reminds me from those turtles, those giant mountain turtles in the Neverending Story.
I don't know.
Hurry up, bro. What's taking so long, you freaking turtle? Look at him. He's totally coming to see us. 500 pounds?
Yeah.
Wow.
He's over 500 because our scale tops at 500.
Dude, that guy is a beast.
Clarence, come here.
Come here, Clarence. So is it true that you can like see how old they are by measuring the rings in their shell? Or is that a myth? Is that a tree? I don't know.
In trees, you can know you can
I always thought like something you could like figure out how old they were by like carting them at the door.
Each year they'll add to the shell, but it's not a direct indication of
how old they are.
It's how much growth.
I thought I read. I had a horrible biology teacher.
And he really likes being pet, so what he'll do is when you actually start petting him, he'll freeze.
Don't put your hands
on him. Yeah, not near
his face. Gage is gonna lose a finger.
So you guys are watching his adoption appointment right now.
So good.
I told him this isn't difficult.
Alright, can you guys reach it all?
Okay. So
if you guys want to reach out and touch a shell, if you can't quite reach, that's okay. But try reaching through the bottom part of the bark.
Can you
reach through here, Princess Tard, right down here. Go through the other one. Can you feel this shell?
There we go.
Whoa, what does it feel like?
Well, we'll try to move him closer
we'll
too,
closer
so don't worry if you guys
need some turtle wax on this baby.
Yeah.
That's cool.
A lot of years.
And tortoise feet.
Or you'll just have really dry skin.
Yeah. Mom, look. Mom, look.
Hey, buddy.
Well, they're at the very end of it.
Whoa, what's that? What's going on now? Okay.
Yes. Wow. There you go. There. Okay.
Don't get your fingers at all close.
Okay,
when
so one at a time.
Just hold it at the very end. Okay?
One at a time, guys.
Right. He's going to go first, Princess Tard.
So,
go ahead. Hold it out there. Don't be scared. Just hold it out there.
There you go.
Yeah.
Your turn.
He's so cute.
Hold it. Hold it right there so we can get it.
He can get one more bite out of that. Oh, there it
is. You're the worst turtle feeder ever, dude. Come on. Oh, you're like.
Well, he's gonna get to the bar. So let's let Jessica.
Let's have him back up a little bit.
Yeah. All right. Give me a big.
All these delicious fingers.
Yeah, he's getting a little close. So we're just gonna
try. I love when he goes like
ah. Here you go, buddy.
And try to get it not in the gap that he's got right there.
There
we go.
Perfect.
Yummy.
All right, Claire. He's got a little piece of his beak that kind of chips. So let's hold it this way.
There you go.
Okay, baby Tart, are you gonna feed him?
You wanna try it?
Yeah, ready? Right here, Claire.
Here, I'll let you. Good. Good.
That's a big turtle. Good job.
Look at his mouth. His mouth is so cool.
Ready?
I'll try to go for the side that doesn't have the hole. Oh, good job.
Yep, I can definitely see how you could lose a finger if
you're
not careful.
Kind of a horror story there, huh?
It's a tiny little turtle. Where you are, what you are, if you're not. Hi, turtle. Hey, what you doing there?
So he's not going to even try.
Good. Say, have a good day.
He's a much miniature version of the other one we saw, huh?
Eat.
That's what he eats. He eats his vegetables.
Wow.
Yeah.
Here he comes, Mr. Alligator. Oh, he stopped. I thought he was going to jump in the water. Come come on, happy alligator. Can you get in there and wrestle him? Alligator wrestler? Dude, what's with the Brad Pitt hair, man? It's starting to get long and flowy.
We growing it out?
Growing your hair out, bro?
Yes.
Yes. There he goes, there he goes. Dive, bro. Oh, it's so hot out here. Oh, yeah. Nice. That's refreshing. That's Butch the Bobcat.
There's 20.
Chilling on a barrel.
So what do you think Will is feeding him?
Butch.
Low-calorie yogurt snacks?
He is a carnivore, right?
What do carnivores eat?
They eat meat.
What kind of meat do you think he's feeding them? Some prime rib?
Sit.
Cat that sits, wow.
This Butch, and he's a bobcat, but he might also have some lynx within him.
His mom was a hussy.
He was born with his cage and a fur farm. So fur farms are legal in 38 states.
That's horrible.
Oh my goodness. From the fur farm to a private owner, so someone who kept him as a pet, which is not legal. So he and his cage mate ended up being confiscated by U.S. Fish and Wildlife. Bobcats and lynxes, they have much bigger feet, and that's so that they can walk on top of the snow.
All right, it's about to be a man from Snowy River here.
Ready, Nikki? Come on, you can do it. That's his backup.
Cool. Papa Willie. Yeah, good horsey.
There you go.
Go get a kiss. Go get a kiss. Go kiss him. Don't be scared. Watch, watch. Kiss. Oh, nice.
Oh, okay, okay.
Go get a kiss. Baby Tart, go get a kiss. Say, give me a kiss.
So these people that are right here, they adopted
Nikki. Oh, nice.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn?
That's the misters. They have misters because it's so hot out here. Sing it, Santard.
I forgot.
By the twilight's last gleam.
He probably hears this song all the time. He's like, come on. Do Coming to America, at least, by Neil Diamond.
I've never seen an eagle before.
Well, there you go. You see an eagle right there. That's the national bird. You guys know that's the bird of our country.
Yeah, that's the bird of our country.
Why is it raining?
Ah. Bald eagle.
Because it's hot in there. It's a hot day today, so they have these misters so it doesn't get so hot.
Yeah, you could just jump in that pool, which is so lucky.
Bird.
Say, that's a bird.
Bird.
Say, look, there's a bird.
Bird.
Is he a bird? He's a bird.
Back out in the wild.
A duck.
That's a vulture, not a duck. What are you saying, bro? Whoa.
Good singer.
Yeah, he's practicing for a solo he has. He has a solo in the zoo choir.
And the call that she's doing right now, they come from the rainforest, and they need to communicate to people, or to, I mean, other Simangs, over about 2 miles. You can hear that call.
Oh, I thought she was ordering lunch. Turkey sandwich, no tomatoes! What do you think about that, Rockstar? See a monkey? That's a monkey.
Wow.
A monkey? That's crazy.
Wow, look at that. Look
he's
how big
he is. 21 years old.
I think it's Malachi.
How old do they get?
Well, in the wild, they would only be about around 15 years. They would only live about that long in captivity, about 20
he's
to 25 years.
Life,
yeah.
He's going to play tug of war with Shay.
Do you want
to
do the tug of war and then
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, can I do the tug of war?
So when you, who's playing?
Me.
You're playing. You're probably going to put child down.
Okay. Hold this,
baby. And, just when you're playing, so you're actually not going to pull against him because he kind of releases randomly sometimes.
Yeah.
And I don't want you to fall on your butt, which has happened. So you'll just sort of try and hold your ground against him.
Okay.
So I'm going to put this through, and you'll just take a few steps back. Watch out.
All right,
I've been
honey.
Training for a long time for this. Out of all the hyena tug-of-war contests I've ever been in, this is the one I'm most nervous.
It's the Olympics of...
The Olympics of tug-of-war hyena.
Okay. Right, Zabuti's gonna
ready,
pull the rope. Come on, Shay. Oh, you
that
won.
Really
you can do that again.
It was more than I expected.
Oh, you can do it.
Pull, 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 p
Yeah, take that. I,
baby, you're so tough.
Here, hold on tight. Whoa.
You've been hyena'd.
Good job, dude. He's strong.
That is amazing.
You're gonna play?
Look, he's back in position.
Hold on.
Take two of you. There you go.
Yeah, both hold on.
Here. Wait,
let's keep the baby
team,
out of my
your
way.
Team.
I'm not
hold
doing
on.
It.
Hold on.
Are you ready? Oh, you let go.
I think that means you
win. Oh, you win.
That was a good try.
Good try.
I don't know if I want
tug of war with the hyena.
Pull, 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 pull.
Nice.
17 years and I've never done this. Come here. Team Romero. Oh, Team Romero.
That's not fair.
You just want to see your teacher bail. Ready?
I'll just go. Okay.
Just pick it up. Pull it. Pull it. Pull, 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 pull. Pull it. Pull, 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 pull.
Oh, yeah.
Good boy.
Cool.
Go,
you don't have the food. He don't want to listen to you. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Stick him up. Oh, wait. I gotta do this first. That was bang.
There, yeah, I get bang.
Okay. Shot him. Oh, he's dead.
Oh, yay.
My top feels nice and cool and soft. Sometimes people think they're gonna be slimy, but it's just because they're shiny. They kind of look like they're slimy, but they're not. Can you touch him?
Can we feel it?
Can you see on his belly? Those are called scoots. He gets along. He scoots along. Did you want to touch him? There you go. Can you touch
cool.
him?
What do you think? Is that scary?
His head is over here. That's why I'm holding him backwards, because his head, remember anything with the mouth might bite? So I'm taking his head over to here where he can't see you guys. There we go. You know, he has all the same pieces and parts inside of him like you do, so he has a stomach and lungs and heart. They're just all in a row. So that's why we don't want to squish him. We don't want to squeeze him. Oh, did you hear what he asked?
Yeah.
That was such a good question. Why is he sticking his tongue out? Do you know?
Because he's breathing.
He's smelling you. Yeah, he's smelling you. He's taking in all the chemicals.
Look at that.
She's a... she is a blue crane. Her name is Delilah.
Why is the head so big on the back?
South Africa.
She's a big brain.
She's actually their national bird. So you know how our national bird is the bald eagle?
Uh-huh.
She's their national bird. She's on a lot of their money.
Oh,
so she's
cool.
Pretty famous there.
Feeding them millworms.
Stay on the grass.
And Delilah here is about 5 years old.
Stay on the grass.
And that's pretty young for blue cranes. They can actually live to be 40.
They're so pretty.
I know. It's hard to believe.
Sleep. The labyrinth.
Yeah, you're right. The labyrinth.
With the tail feathers.
Shake your tail feather. Long legs.
Actually.
Her long legs help her in Africa to walk through the tall grasses.
Almost
are they like fast runners?
Doesn't it look like she has a pretty dress on?
Pretty fast. They can fly too.
Lose them in the train.
She wanted to. We clipped the first layer of her wings. It's completely painless for her just so that she can't completely fly.
Yeah.
But she can still get air and we still run her and fly her down the back road.
Spray her down. It's hot out here.
She was trying to dance with the crane.
Just dancing at her.
She's really trying to dance with this bird. I'm not impressed, Susan.
You didn't like my dancing. Worst dancer ever.
Shay, quit trying to compete with the crane, okay?
I knew. I could see it in her eyes. She's like, this dude is trying to like scoot up on me in the club, and he's not. She's kind of like.
Ladies, that's what you do if a guy tries to dance with you. Just you just attack.
Oh, attack my dad again.
All right, Princess Star, what are we about to see?
A
show. We're about to see a show, huh? And Suntard has agreed to be in a banana eating contest with a baboon. Are you nervous? You better not lose, dude. You better not lose or I'll be disappointed.
So Suntard is going to have a banana eating contest with a baboon, and I told him if he doesn't win, he's going to walk home. Right?
There's no way I'm going to walk.
So thanks to Brendan and Chris. You guys are awesome. They're the ones that gave us a tour and gave us all the helpful information, learning about all these cool animals.
And just being here has been really awesome. We got some backstage access. I got to tug of war with a hyena.
Want me to go perform?
Yeah, let's go see you do a little dance. Stay right there.
I was attacked by a bird. Hey, get out of there!
Stand right there. Dance right there.
I have to be in there.
Oh, you only perform if you're on the stage. All right, I understand. You have to start shoveling horse dung if you go behind there.
So this is Ceylon. She's an Indian python. She's going backwards. She's big, huh? What do you guys think? You ever seen a snake this big?
No.
No?
My She's pretty amazing.
Go she weighs a little over 70 pounds. She's very heavy. It takes four of us to carry her out. And she eats meat, so that means she's a carnivore. And she has a special way of getting her prey, and that she hugs them really, really hard. And then she eats them whole. And for us, that'd be really difficult because our jaws open like this. Can everybody do this? Our jaws open like
chomp,
this.
Chomp, chomp,
for her jaws, they open like this and then like this.
Okay, we had a beautiful day at the zoo, and now we are making baby tard pink alicious cupcakes.
Wait,
oh, don't those look amazing? And of course, we are making these cupcakes by scratch. Yeah, not today. We'll try another time. We'll try that way another time. All right, let's mix it up some more.
Okay, is that as pink as you want it? Do you want any more pink, or is that pink enough?
Baby tart, is that pink enough, or do you want more pink?
I want more pink.
Okay.
More pink it is.
More pink. You want to turn pink. There we go. Three more drops. Okay, I think that might be enough.
Well, I would do three more.
I think that's officially pink enough. Don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. We don't want to all turn out like Pinkalicious.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah. What are you guys looking at?
I'm looking at the cupcakes!
Fruit cakes! They look beautiful. Let's squeeze in here. I want to see. Let me see. Oh, don't they look delectable? They remind me, for some reason, of Alice in Wonderland. Why do they remind me of Alice in Wonderland?
And they're pink.
They're pink and Pinkalicious. Delicious.
Pink of delicious.
Here is the best part. The messiest, but the best. Where we get to put the sugar on top and the strawberries and the sprinkles.
And sprinkles.
And the way the book goes. Hey! No! Okay, wait. Do we need to talk about cooking rules? If you're using a knife to spread, you cannot put it in your mouth.
I need another thing.
Yes, you need something else. Now, if you are spreading with a knife, do you put the knife in your mouth?
No!
No! Why?
Because get the germs on your cookie.
Oh, that's right. Nobody else wants to eat your germs. Here they are, the Pinkalicious cupcakes!
Yeah.
Yeah! And how does the story go, guys? If we eat too many of them, what color are we going to turn?
Pink!
Let's not eat too many, okay?
If we eat too many, then we turn red. And then if we start eating green vegetables, then we'll turn green, and then we'll turn back to normal.
Then we'll turn back to normal, huh?
No, so this is right. First, if you eat a bunch of cupcakes, you're pink. Then after you eat one more, you're red. Then when you eat green stuff, your ears twiggle and your feet twitch and you twitch. And then you turn normal again. You turn normal again.
Yes. All right, let's eat.
All right, dude, you ready for the show?
Yeah.
Okay, this is our second zoo show today. We're getting a second show. All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, people of all ages, welcome Chimpanzee, we'll see what she is.
My name's Rosalinda. She likes eating watermelon seeds. Target. She's from Australia.
Target.
Good job. She's good at jumping. She can run really fast.
Wow.
She's good at running. Usually, she has put something around your wrist. And you put the thing on her.
You're ruining the zoo show, you dancing chimpanzee.
That was my niece. Can you get this off?
Your animal talks?
No. Don't talk.
So we learned that they do target training at Moore Park. Look. Show your target training. Show your target training.
Target.
Which means they put their nose to the round thing. And then we're also noticing that every time the animal did a behavior, they would do it like, it had this little clicker. that they would click to reinforce the behavior. So Princess Tard is demonstrating that here. What are the white spots behind her ears? What does that do?
It makes her so. If it's like raining, it's like a little umbrella to keep her warm and safe.
Oh, okay.
But only her head.
Do you guys remember those cats where they said why? Why'd they have those white spots behind their ears?
So, like, predators think that, like, their eyes, and it's like, oh no, I shouldn't breathe.
Well, it's. Okay, good. I'm doing the show.
If the babies are like in tall grass and they can see the baby mama, the mama, and they'll notice it's the mama by the stripes. So
that's right. Those are exactly the two reasons. Sorry to interrupt your presentation.
Okay. Next, her name is going to be Princess Charlie.
Next presentation.
She's Cheetah. She lives in Australia. She lives in Australia.
Get back from you.
And he disappears out the door. So is this animal an omnivore, a carnivore, or an herbivore?
It's a cheetah.
What is a cheetah? What does a cheetah eat?
They eat meat.
So it's a carnivore. Say, this is a carnivore.
This is a carnivore.
Oh, scary. Carnivores are scary.
Walker's chasing me down.
All right, it's time for bed. Let's say our prayers and go to sleep.
Hey guys, this is Clarence the Tortoise. Thanks for watching me eat some carrots. I love carrots. I wish I had some carrots right now. Anyway,
quiet, I'm doing the unslate.
I was wondering how you could do that.
These are delicious Clarence carrots, the carrots, the Clarence.
Hey, we're in the unslate, Clarence. Watch your language.
I didn't cuss none shame. I'm Clarence the Turtle.
All right, hey,
you're
big
really
thanks.
Having fun with that, aren't you?
I'm Clarence, dog. Me and Clarence are homeboys. If you guys knew how tight me and Clarence were, you wouldn't even like step. You wouldn't even dare to step. You'd trip, Rick, step. Thank you to Chris and Brendan for giving us a grand tour of the Moorpark Zoo. Baby Tard had a fantastic fifth birthday. She really did. She had a lot of fun, and they were so excited that morning we woke up. It was a cool behind-the-scenes look at what goes on at the zoo. So we hope you guys had a great time watching us at the zoo. Right, Clarence?
That's right, everybody. Don't forget to thumbs up today's video. If you do, I'll give you some carrots.
All right, you say something now.
I just love Clarence. I just love
what? Clarence better back up off my girl, dog. You know what I'm saying? All right. Love you guys. You know the deal. Click on the clickety-clack. Love you. See you tomorrow.